Er stand im Halle Darts Championship und er hat die UK Open gewonnen. The Asp, Nathan Aspinall. Von Nathan Aspinall ist aktuell in absoluter Topform die Nummer 9 der Welt. Er steht bei 10 Major-Siegen und er hat es zuletzt geschafft, innerhalb von 8 Tagen 3 PDC-Titel zu gewinnen. The Machine, James Way!
Slam champion Gerwin Price, world number 2 Rob Cross, two-time world champion Adrian Lewis, the number 2 seed Ian Diamond White, five-time major finalist Dave Chisnell, and the former Champions League of Darts winner Mensur Suljovic. Not a bad quarter-final lineup so far, and the quality is not going to be diluted with the two winners from the final two games of this afternoon's session. Mighty Michael van Gerwen and Raymond van Barneveld square off to round off the third round of the German Darts Open. But before that, it's the European champion and the UK Open champion fighting it out for a spot in the last eight. James Wade, a winner of 3 titles already this year, one of the 4 men in darts. He very nearly beat MVG on Thursday night in the Premier League. But he's looking very good for a spot at the O2 and the playoffs, looking to win that title 10 years after he first claimed it. But Nathan Aspinall has just catapulted himself into the big time this year.
Gentlemen, first leg is Nathan to throw first. Game on.
Chris Murphy is in the box to see this clash of major champions.
Yeah, James Wade has always been in the big time. But
100.
He's returned to the winner's circle in the last, well, year or so. Those back-to-back TV titles that he picked up at the end of 2018.
140.
And he's already won a hat-trick of titles in 2019, which could yet turn out to be his most successful year in terms of picking up tournament wins. But if he's going to win this one, then he will have to thank the hand that Lady Luck played when he survived 6 match darts against Luke Humphries yesterday.
Yes, he was extremely fortunate. 5-2 down, won 4 legs, but survived 6 darts, as you say, and aided by Luke apparently suffering from a kind of panic attack or something of that ilk up on stage in the final few legs.
Yeah, Humphries revealed afterwards that it's something that he suffered with for his entire career as a professional darts player. And that he's going to go away and try and get it sorted finally, because it seemed to get worse in that particular match.
135.
I wish him well. I'm sure it is something that can be sorted. As Wade looks to tee up tops.
100.
Not quite.
69.
But James Wade waiting on 80 is still pressure on any finish.
Oh, that looked so good, that first one, didn't it? And he slid in alongside it for a 15 darter and a hold of throw. Nathan Aspinall does have a couple of wins over Wadey in his career, but he's lost 4 times to the machine.
99.
But they haven't met since Nathan Aspinall went from a player who's won one floor title to a World Championship semi-finalist and a UK Open champion. Not since he's burst into the top 16 in the world has he gone up and tested himself against James Wade. Fascinating clash, this one.
Yeah,
and the only European Tour meeting was won by Aspinall. That was when James Wade was a qualifier. 100. At the back end of 2017. Played in the first round.
98.
And you have seen a few players from the top of world darts have to work their way back, but James Wade never dropped that low, did he? Been a mainstay of the world's top 16 for a long time. That 180 has left him on a two darter.
121. James
Dubois, 63. But Aspinall has recovered well there. Wade often only needs one dart.
43.
But he needed more than one there, and Nathan Aspinall 46. Can double his lead.
Yeah, it was 6-1 when they met on the Euro Tour in the match I just mentioned, and Nathan Aspinall has broken early on here.
And
he's going to throw to lead 3-0.
Well, he has had significant victories, Nathan, this year. Obviously, the UK Open was enormous, but
100.
There were signs before that he was doing bits. Obviously, the World Championship semi-final, but he had a quarter-final and a semi on the tour. He'd beaten Van Gerwen heavily on the tour on one of the streaming boards. You go to PDC Facebook page, they've probably still got that video up of Nathan winning 6-1. Absolutely lethal on the finishers in that game. And he may have to do something similar here to beat Wadey.
Yeah, we know that he's got the special stuff in him, Nathan Aspinall, that is coming out more and more since he did become a major champion.
Well, that's
remarkable win at Minehead. James Wade, incidentally, the last man to beat him at Minehead. Knocked him out of the Players' Championship final at the end of last year.
Well, that's it. I mean, you know, all the talk after Aspinall had won it, there was obviously a huge amount of congratulations.
100.
But at the same time, it was... Well, by the way, Nathan, people are going to be gunning for you now. Let's see how you deal with that.
He's not going to deal with the 1-2-1 in this visit, but he could be halfway home when he returns.
What's he doing? Oh, no, he did move to the 18s. Thought he was staying on the 20s there, which might have left him a bogey number.
Double 10. Usually a friend to James Wade, and it's a friend to Nathan Aspinall, who leads the machine 3-0. Now, we have seen Peter Wright, the number 4 seed, the highest seeded departure of this tournament so far, go out, but not really a surprise against Dave Chisholm, who produced some sublime stuff. But Nathan Aspinall is one of only a handful of qualifiers to have made it through to the final day, and 60. This would be something of a scalp, bearing in mind the form that James Wade has been in.
5.
140.
James Wade, of course, a man who has hit a 9-darter on the Euro Tour this year.
Yeah, one of 3, Dan.
All over the place. Bored of him now.
Yeah, we had the curse of Ross Smith, didn't we, when he hit a 9-darter in 2013. We didn't get one for 5 years. Now we've got the curse of Michael Van Gerwen, who, after hitting one last year, has seen everybody start hitting them on the European Tour.
They're the kind of curses I like.
Including Steve Beaton this weekend.
Well, again, Nathan.
180.
Oh, it's a fabulous setup shot from him.
81.
Got to go 12 segments. Now it's the ball.
Yeah,
and he pins it. James Wade, fabulous stuff. It is supernatural at times how Wade seems to maintain his composure even under enormous pressure.
Yeah. 59. Just battered off back-to-back 180s from his opponent to win that leg. And look at the figures in this one.
Well, this has been coming from Aspinall. On the average, 96 in seeing off Dennis Nielsen 6-1, and then averaged 100 in beating the ferret Johnny Clayton 6-3. it is becoming, we are, as you said, it's becoming more often that we're seeing Aspinall playing in this manner. It was interesting hearing Nathan actually, after his win against Johnny Elmar, RMC asked him about that little bit of his throw where he hops up on his front foot, and he said, "I've been trying to eliminate it. It's a lot less pronounced than it used to be." James Wade is a player who has completely cut one of those little hops out of his game, and lo and behold, it coincided with him starting playing brilliantly again.
11 or the treble.
No.
Well, that was Plum in the centre of the treble 14. A flyer from James Wade.
151.
No harm done. Yeah, just to go back to that point, that was something that crept into James Wade's game and then was taken out of it, whereas Aspinall has always had
been
that.
It, yeah.
So it might be a little bit harder to get rid of. Can James Wade get rid of this?
Eight.
Well, it isn't his favourite bit of the board, but it is still a surprise to see James Wade miss three darts at any double.
On the fifth leg, Nathan Aspinall.
And to be honest, Nathan appears to be in one of those moods where you're going to be very surprised to see him miss more than a couple of darts at double at any stage.
140.
Well, he could set up, should MVG defeat Barney, a rematch of that brilliant performance on the Pro Tour. Different kettle of fish on the stage, isn't it? But Michael van Gerwen's not going to have it all his own way this weekend, because we know that Raymond van Barneveld has on occasion produced inspired performances against the world number one. Aspinall's handed out that battering earlier on this year, and James Wade has played him twice in the Premier League this year and not lost.
Hasn't lost, yeah. And he'll probably... Wadey, I think, was a bit disappointed not to have done the double over him, because his first emotion was kind of disappointment at not winning on Thursday night. Now then, Aspinall. The setup play has been very good from him.
126.
Can't quite leave a finish, but he is breathing down Wadey's neck. It is 103 average for Aspinall, similar for James Wade here, but this...
50.
Well, he's only scored 50. And James Wade's got problems here. Real problems.
Came back from 5-2 down, didn't he, to beat Luke Humphreys? He would have to come back from 5-1 down.
140. James Wade, 150.
How many times have we seen that? Oh, another one there. Oh, there's Wading, and then there's this. Oh, James Wade, behave!
So, next is Nathan to throw first. Game on.
Well, how many times have we seen that kind of thing from the machine, who was facing the prospect of a 5-1 deficit had he not taken out 158?
121.
But it was once again the case of cometh the moment, cometh the machine.
A 140 to leave 42 and doesn't get a shot because Wade pins a 158. He'd gone back-to-back 180s to leave 81 and doesn't get a shot because Wade pinned 81 on the bullseye. Nathan Aspinall will feel, I could have had this game won, but James Wade has just been...
James Wade.
Yeah, well...
120.
Uber Wade.
Does have the knack of coming back, doesn't he, James Wade? Because he just never seems flustered, never seems like he's out of a match. So he said we watched the Pro Tour final against Jeffrey Desvarne when he was 4-0 down, could have been 5-0 down, but once he started getting in the ascendancy, it seemed like almost inevitable that Wade was going to win. Aspinall's got half a dozen darts to complete this 120 checkout.
60.
Halves his score.
Well, Nathan Aspinall was watching the back end of that Dave Chisnell game, just backstage here, and
He was looking at the numbers and going, oh, this
41.
Is this is
Nathan,
just
you require 60.
Dave Chisnell averaging 140 front nine. This performance is right up there with it for me because it has been superb so far from Nathan.
20.
But that is a slip. And he can't do 158 and 160, can he? In back-to-back legs.
But it wouldn't have been that surprising, would it, to see from James Wade? But Aspinall has a chance to go within one, which is done.
Yeah,
just to put into context that first nine stat in the Dave Chisnell performance, that meant he was scoring an average of 408 points with his first nine darts.
You're on a two-darter after nine in every leg. You're doing all right.
It helps.
Yeah, it does help. I'm a little bit disappointed that he only walked away with 106 average, because it could have been anything.
Yeah, it was looking, for the most part, like it was going to at least break the record for this tournament.
But Nathan Aspinall averaging around about 103, 104 with 50% on doubles. Now, that can win you titles. And watch out, anybody who comes up against Nathan Aspinall, particularly this weekend, because that is his third 180. And he continues to impress. He's getting better and better and better, and has been for the last few months, Nathan Aspinall.
We might be about to see Nathan average more than Dave Chisnell did in that fabulous performance. Back-to-back maximums for the second time in the match.
180!
And this time, Wadey cannot stop him from getting darts for the leg, and indeed the match. Nathan Aspinall dropped
16.
Off the tour, had a year on the Challenge Tour, came back stronger. And he gets stronger and stronger and stronger. A 10-darter for the Asp, who has powered past one of the four men in the world. 108 average almost. That is as good as we've seen at the German Darts Open this weekend. And who knows, maybe the Asp could pick up a European Tour title this weekend.
Applause for James Wade. Thank you very much for coming to Saarbrücken. The machine scheidet aus und hat das Wort Rubbish auf den Lippen, ist nicht ganz zufrieden mit dem Scoring gewesen, aber was für ein Auftritt von Nathan Aspinall, 108er Average, damit kann er jeden schlagen hier im Turnier. Nathan, congratulations, great game, average of 108.
Ooh. Ooh, lovely.
I mean, James is really one of the best in these days at the moment.
Yeah, I play James all the time, and he's such a hard player to play and to beat. And I don't know what it was. I felt so relaxed that I just thought I was playing in my back room, to be fair. And I played really well, scored really well, finished well. And I'm happy to win in my first quarter final in the Euro Tour. So.
For me, you were the example where you can see what self-confidence can change on a dartboard on an aircraft. That's amazing. I mean, if we look back, I would say 6 months, you were a different player.
Yeah, definitely. You know, we can all throw darts. We're all good at darts, but it's in between the years, and you know, the confidence I've got over the last 3 or 4 months. You know, you can't buy that confidence and experience. And I'm just loving playing darts. I'm loving playing in front of the crowd, and you know, it's brilliant. I'm happy to be here tonight.
If you could pick MVG or Raymond van Barneveld, who would it be?
None of them. you know. I'm not bothered, you know, they're both quality players. You know, I've never played Michael on a stage. You know, it'd be nice to play him on a stage. And, you know, last time I beat him 6-1, so you never know.
Okay, see you later. Thank you very much, Nathan. Nathan Aspinall. Der sagt, ach, warum nicht gegen